Welcome to our Top Floor Motivation YouTube channel. There's nothing better than getting a boost to help you get motivated to exercise. In this video, we want to help you start and crush your exercise goals by giving you 10 quick and powerful tips to motivate you to exercise now. Are you tired of procrastinating or just can't seem to get started or stay consistent with exercising? Well, keep watching this video until the end to start making positive changes now. Most of us are aware of the many health benefits of exercising, but finding the discipline and motivation to start training and continuing with it is often the hardest part. The health benefits of regular exercise are not easy to ignore. Everyone benefits from exercise, regardless of age, gender, or physical ability. Exercise is any bodily activity that enhances the maintenance of physical fitness and overall health and wellness. Regular exercise can help you stay energetic, healthy as you age, and plays a vital role in preventing health diseases. The benefits of exercise affect all body systems. Exercise can reduce stress and anxiety, improve self-confidence, boost dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, and endorphins, or happy chemicals, in your brain, increase brain power, sharpen memory, and increase your muscle and bone strength. It also helps in preventing blood sugar fluctuations, reduces heart disease, obesity, cardiovascular diseases, and cancer. Whether you're just starting your fitness tasks or in desperate need of some motivation to keep going, you can find it in this educational, inspirational, and empowering video content. Exercise is divided into three categories: aerobic, anaerobic, and agility training. Aerobic exercise aims to improve the use of oxygen in the body and increases cardiovascular endurance. Some aerobic exercises include swimming, jump roping, dancing, and long-distance running. These exercises can enhance your endurance by increasing your body's ability to store energy. Anaerobic exercise is involved in strength and resistance workouts. Some examples are weightlifting, pull-ups, and push-ups. Sprinting is a highly intensive activity and type of exercise that can yield great results. While other exercises are suitable for the heart and lungs, anaerobic exercise provides fewer benefits for cardiovascular health than aerobic exercise and uses lower calories. However, it is more effective than aerobic exercise for building muscle and improving strength. Agility training aims to improve the ability to maintain control while speeding up, slowing down, and changing direction. This exercise stretches and lengthens muscles. The prior goal is to improve the range of exercises, which helps to reduce the risk of injuries. Some examples are playing tennis, badminton, and volleyball. Exercise is the way to good health and a sound mind. The daily practice of some physical exercise does not mean to put stress on the body, but it is a stress-relieving activity. Good health is obligatory for doing good exercise. Exercise makes you physically fitter and improves your mental health. Fitness is not just about running on a treadmill for hours in the gym, it can be a dance class or a new practice like a bear crawl or crab walk. These exercises can be achieved through 20 to 40 minutes of mid-intensity exercises, 4 times a week, or 20 to 50 minutes of intense exercise, 3 times a week. The thought of exercising can make you quit before you start. If you are looking to get and stay motivated to exercise, consider the following tips and quotes to get long-term success. Number 1. Set goals. Begin with simple goals and then progress to longer-range goals. Remember to make your goals realistic and attainable. It's easier to get frustrated and give up if your goals are overblown. In an instance, if you haven't exercised in a while, it's advisable to set a short-term goal, which might be to walk 10 minutes a day, 5 days a week. Even short amounts of exercise can be beneficial. An intermediate goal might be to walk 35 minutes, 5 days a week. A long-term goal might be to achieve a 10-kilometer walk. For you to become a healthy adult, consider doing at least 150 minutes of moderate aerobic activity or 75 minutes of sturdy aerobic activity or a combination of moderate and vigorous activity. Greater time spent on exercise will always provide greater benefits. Consider consulting with a medical professional or doctor, or get a physical before starting any exercise routine. A little progress each day adds up to big results. Number 2. Work out at your own pace. Doing too much too quickly can increase the chances and risk of injuries when it's best to develop a stable practice. Set targets based on the goals you want to accomplish at the beginning of the regimen and celebrate every small win to boost confidence without comparing your progress to others. Let your unique journey be your own. You may not be there yet, but you are closer than you were yesterday. Number 3. Make it fun. Getting started with your workout can be difficult. Find exercises or sports that you enjoy, and then vary the exercises to make them interesting. If you are not enjoying your practice, try something different. You can include a dance class, as dancing is an interesting and easy exercise. If you like to work out at home, hook yourself with online videos of several types of exercise classes, such as boxing and high-intensity interval training. Or take a walk or jog. Discover your hidden athletic talent or interest and get lost in the thrill and enjoyment of a healthier, fitter, leaner, and new you. Exercise doesn't have to be boring. Once you see results, it becomes an addiction. Number 4. Create a support group of friends. It's awesome when you don't have to exercise alone. Inviting friends or work colleagues to join you when you exercise or go on walks can be motivating when you have support. You can work out with your partner. You can also work out virtually. However, self-empowerment comes from truly learning to become self-motivated when there's no one to push you but yourself. You can do it. Push yourself because no one else is going to do it for you. Number 5. Reward yourself. At the end of each exercise session, take deserved breaks and minutes to savor your good feelings. This type of inward reward can help you to make a long-term commitment to regular exercise. When you reach a longer-range goal, treat yourself with good exercise gifts and rewards that can boost your morale. You are one workout away from a better mood. Number 6. Trainers and teachers can be helpful. You should start a vigorous regimen with a personal instructor or trainer. They can provide motivation and guidance, helping you to track your goals and stay dedicated. The best investment you can make is your own health. Number 7. Vary your exercises. Change your exercise routine and program weekly. Mixed exercise helps in working different muscle groups and increases the range of benefits. If you enjoy swimming, try switching your swimming strokes. Champions keep playing until they get it right. Number 8. Make it a habit. After weeks of regular exercise, an exercise routine becomes a habit, even if you find it difficult. The benefits of regular exercise are wide-reaching and should form a part of every individual's day to help them remain healthy. Motivation is what gets you started. Habit is what keeps you going. Number 9. Delete guilt. Get super real with yourself. If you miss out on a day or two of exercises, then do not beat yourself up or go back to your former unhealthy habits. Accept that fact, prepare mentally for such setbacks, and don't let a misstep be an excuse for you to give up. Don't give up because you had a bad day. Forgive yourself and do better tomorrow. Number 10. Track your progress. Document your workouts, whether you do it online or in an old-school fitness journal. Seeing improvements, whether you are doing more reps or working out more often, makes you want to keep going. Stepping outside of your comfort zone, starting your exercise routine when you don't feel like it, and witnessing your progress helps you to break mental barriers and resistance to change. I don't count my sit-ups. I only start counting when it starts hurting. That is when I start counting, because then it really counts. That's what makes you a champion. In closing, you should never give up on your physical health and wellness. Mentally conquering the barriers that keep you from getting started is the first battle that you can overcome to get and stay motivated to exercise. Think of the rewards and health benefits you can reap, as well as the negative risks of failing health that can be prevented if you start exercising now. Getting and staying motivated to exercise can make you mentally and physically fitter and supercharge your health and life. Your body can stand almost anything. It's your mind that you have to convince. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, feel free to like, subscribe, hit the notification button, share, or leave a comment or thumbs up below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the top floor.